The Canon R6, let's talk about it and why I think it's the most underrated camera in 2022. So let's just jump right into it.
Hey, what's up, guys? I didn't realize this until I started editing this video. The wind noise is horrible, and I apologize for that. My window is right there, and yeah, I didn't realize it was that bad. So let's jump back into the video. And again, I'm sorry for the audio.
I bought this camera over a year ago, and I have to say, it has absolutely been my favorite camera I've ever used. So this camera, it was just a game changer for me. And I know that's something that you hear a lot of people say on YouTube, but it really, really was. It was coming from the R, which I really like that camera. I'm still filming on it right now, use it in my YouTube studio. Great camera, but I was just like, man, for $24.99, I believe is what it was, you got 4K basically uncropped. You got 120 1080p, which was pretty good. C-Log at the time, better autofocus, things like that. So it was really easy for me to upgrade. It's not a perfect camera, but what is? But I will tell you, in 2022, there's not been one camera that's grabbed my attention and made me want to upgrade. One of the biggest reasons is the used market. And yes, it's still hard to get cameras, but you can still pick this thing up for a fairly decent price used, and it gets you into the R mount or the RF mount of lenses, which is really incredible. I'm one of these guys that believes that lenses are more important than camera bodies. So you need to think about what system do you want to buy into? And as far as lenses, there's not a better system than Canon. The 4K image is incredible. It really holds its own. No, it's not 8K. No, it does not have 4K 120. We can get into that in just a little bit. But it does have an incredible image, 4K 60, which I think is plenty good enough. I think 120 has been way overused, and it's kind of how when drones first came out, you know, it was really the cool thing, and then now it's like everywhere, it's not a big deal. 120's kind of become the same thing, and I think that makes you a lazy shooter. Another reason that I chose this guy right here over the R5 is the fact that this is way better in low light. This is not gonna look like a Sony. No, Sony's still the king. Sony's still the best when it comes to low light. But for a Canon camera, this thing is phenomenal in low light, especially teamed up with something like the 28-70 with an F2 aperture. What else do you need? I mean, really, honestly, what else do you need? This thing is amazing. There's no noise hardly at all in the image, and it just really has a really good look. Another reason this thing is amazing still in 2022 is Canon keeps doing firmware updates on this thing. The most recent firmware update really changed the autofocus system on this camera. It really, really added some cool features, and I really like it. The thing about this camera though, when it really became a professional workhorse for me, is when they dropped C-Log 3 into this camera. That really made a difference. The dynamic range on this camera is not the best, but I think with C-Log 3, it's something like 14 stops dynamic range. I don't get technical here, but all I can tell you is it works. It's great. It's a lot better than the R was, way better than the R was. It's better than the C-Log, the original C-Log that came out when this camera first dropped. So the fact that Canon keeps giving us firmware updates and they're committed to this camera, it's still a good reason to get into this and buy this in 2022. So let's talk about photography for just a minute. I am mainly a videographer. I do a little bit of photography work from time to time, but I can tell you that 20 megapixels is plenty. I'm gonna say it again. It's plenty, guys. It is all you're gonna need. I have blown up some of these prints and they look amazing, but the way that this camera renders an image, it's sharp. It's really sharp, especially with the right glass. It's so, so good. Another big thing that I loved about this camera when it came out was the fact that it shot 422 10-bit. And if you don't know what that means, basically, and I'm not gonna get technical, you have more colors to work with, more information to work with your image when it comes to color grading. And you can push those colors just a little bit further and just do a little bit more with them. And it's just a lot easier to work with. So the biggest con for me with this camera is the infamous Canon wobble. And by now, I'm sure you know what that is. If not, look it up, but it is a real thing and there is not a workaround, nothing you can do unless you just don't shoot wide. If you get above 24 millimeters, then you'll start to see that Canon wobble and you know, you're gonna be just fine, but the edges are gonna be wobbly and warped and it's just not a good look. And a lot of times when I'm vlogging, I'll just turn IBIS completely off. Just turn it off. There is no way to leave your image stabilization on a lens on and turn IBIS off. Can't do it. You either have to have it either on or off, which is really stupid. That's my biggest complaint with this camera is that. That drives me absolutely insane. The second thing that is probably gonna make you hesitant in buying this camera, and for me it has not been an issue, never, not one time, is the overheating. That was the biggest cripple hammer that happened when these cameras were released. And I think they marketed them wrong because these are pretty much a photography's camera first with amazing video features. I don't shoot long format content. You know, most of my clips are 2 minutes, 5 minutes, you know, 30 seconds, 10 seconds. That's kind of how I shoot and put things together. So for me, it's never been an issue, but if you shoot long format content, you might want to think about that because I've never had it overheat and I've shot 30 minutes, the record limit on this thing, and it's never overheated. I live in Arkansas, it gets really hot here and that's never been an issue. But if that's something that you're worried about, maybe look at something like the R5C, which doesn't have those issues, but you're gonna be spending a lot more money. That's really the only negatives that I have with this camera. So those are kind of my thoughts. That's my 1 year, I guess, thought, a little bit over 1 year. But it's definitely worth it in 2022. So if you're looking at a video camera, a video system to jump into, check out this guy. Check out the Canon EOS R6. And if I'm saying that wrong, let me know in the comments. So we'll see you in the next video. Peace.